Hi children, have a great day. So before going to start our session, let's start with prayer, right? So be in position and listen to me. Asato ma satgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityo ma amritam gamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Fine children, relax yourself and slowly open your eyes. Nice. So what are we seeing about? We are seeing about motion and measurement, right? So in this we saw about the evolution of transport, how the transport has been developed from ancient time to till now, right? So what is motion? Moving from one place to another place is called motion. So in this we study about who is observer, what is observer, what is state of rest and what is state of motion, right? Next we saw about some of the types of motions: rectilinear motion, rotational, circular, periodic, oscillatory, vibratory and random. The object that moves in straight line is called rectilinear. If an object moves in circle path about a fixed point is called circular motion. And if an object rotate along its axis is called rotatory motion. If an object moves in particular period of time, again it moves in a particular interval of time, it is said to be in periodic motion. The to and fro motion of an object is called oscillatory. Then vibratory, if we hit something, if hit an empty vessel or if we hit a string, it will start to vibrate. That it tends to be vibratory motion. And in random motion, the object will exhibits in random path. It doesn't show any definite path, right? So today we are going to see about measurement, right? So it is the term which is used to count something, which is used for counting some distance or a quantity, right? So we usually measure mass in kilogram, length in meter, and to determine some quantities of objects or liquid or objects as liters or dozens, right? So these terms are tend to called standard, right? In order to measure anything, it is compared with fixed number or standard. These terms are referred as standard. For example, a kilogram, 1000 gram equal to 1 kilogram. Similarly, 100 centimeter equal to 1 meter. 1000 milliliters equal to 1 liter. Okay, and 12 numbers, object with numbers of 12 tends to be a dozen. Right, so these are fixed, that is standard. We cannot change these numbers, so these terms are referred as standard, right? And it is called unit. The kilogram, dozen, liters, meter, these are tends to define as unit. Would you clear? So here are some examples for that. The physical quantity and numerical values and its units. The physical quantity, for example, if you are going to measure a weight of an object, say it might be around 10 kilograms. So the weight, that particular measurement, will expressed in two parts. One is the numerical part and another one is the unit part, as shown here. Here the weight of that particular object is 10 kilograms, which has two parts, that is 10, the numerical part, kilograms, that is the unit part. Okay, similarly, if we measure a length such as 2 meter, it also has two parts, that is numerical part and unit part, and the time. If you are going to measure the time, that is 1 hour, 1 hour 40 minutes, 2 minutes 30 seconds, like that, right? That minutes, seconds are unit parts, and the numbers referred as, tends to be referred as numerical part, right? So the separation between two points, the measurements of the separation between two points is called distance. in early times, people used their body parts to measure these distance, right? So such type of measurements are called non-standard measurements. So what is it is called? Non-standard measurements, right? So some of the non-standard measurements are foot. A foot is the length from heel to the big toe, okay, of a normal person. Then fathom, it is the distance between the two stretched arms, okay. The distance will calculate between the tips of two stretched arm is called one fathom, right. The stride, it is the distance covered in a step, okay. Then inch, it is the smallest unit of earth length. It is the smaller unit of length, which is equal to 1 by 12th of the foot. Next, cubit. It is an ancient type of measurement, right? It is measured with tip of the finger to the elbow. How the measurement will be done? Using the tip of the middle finger to the elbow, right? And the hand span. Here, the tips of the measurements will done with the help of tips of the little finger to the tip of the thumb. This is called one hand span, right? And then yard, it will measure from chin to the outstretched hand of one side, okay. So 1 yard equal to 3 feet. In this way, in early times, the people used to measure. Okay, would you clear about the measurement, children? So today we saw about measurement. Measurement contains two part. One is the numerical part and another was the unit part. Unit is nothing but the standard by which a measurement can be done, right? In early times, people used their body parts for this measurement, right? We also saw some early types of measurements, right? So today is about this. So note down your homework. Take your workbook, page number 9 and the 11th question. What is the difference between periodic and vibratory motion? And the 12th one, why did people need advancement in transportation during modern period? Do your work and upload it in Google Classroom app, right? So we can see the remaining topic in next session. Till then, stay connected. Stay safe. Bye.